place. So from collections from Vakligen, from Leiden, from Amsterdam, everything in Netherlands, they just put it in one place. Kasi dati, hiwa-hiwalay yung mga specimen nila. So they realized na mas madali pag ganito. So their storage cabinets is medyo still underwork pa siya kasi kakalipat lang nila. But ito yung buong ano nila, just for bovids and cervids. So even they separated it per taxa. So yung 23 floors nila separated per taxa, and they also separated the type specimen. So their type specimen, they put it in the lower floor, in the second floor, para daw pag nagkaroon ng disgrasya, yun yung una nilang isi-save. So if there would be earthquake or fire, all of their type specimen are just in one place. Yun yung una nilang isi-save, yung sinabi ng curator. And then, yeah, also they have three rooms, which is sinaparate din nila yung mga malalaking big animals, small animals, and yeah, they have the one of the biggest collection as well. And the good thing with their, what I was amazed with their tagging is meron na siyang QR code. So if you need something about details of this specimen, isa-scan mo lang siya. And even their database, you can already see most of the information of the species that you need. So saan siya kinuha, ano yung location niya, and even pictures. So yung may mga researchers sila na nagtitake ng pictures, they also ask sometimes kung yung mga picture para ilagay nila sa database para makita na yun yung available na meron sila. And yeah, they also have some work area for the guests as well. So Institute of Zoology in Beijing, they only have like 3 million and 36,000 mammals. They also have compactor cabinets. And inside the compactor cabinets are like this. So nakahang yung mga sorry, medyo bias ako sa bovids and cervids kasi yun yung sa collection ko. And they also have like ganito yung tags din nila. I was amazed when I saw this one kasi ano siya sus Filipinensis sa area mismo namin sa Malalag. But I didn't know, kahit tinanong ko yung parents ko, hindi nila alam na meron palang baboy ramo doon. So that's how important I realized that really is important to study to see collections and Natural History Museum, because we would know yung distribution ng mga species natin, that we will see that these species have been distributed in this area before, but now wala na yung distribution nila. So from there, madideduce mo kung saan siya, saan sila dati. Apo. And then they also provide a work area for the guests. Lastly is the Kunming Natural History Museum. Medyo konti lang siya, 690,000 specimens and 20,000 are mammals. And also they have compactor cabinets and naka-boxes na rin yung mga specimen nila. And then this is inside the compactor cabinet. And also they have their tags is in Chinese. So yun lang yung naging problema ko doon kasi naka-Chinese siya. So hindi ko siya ma-translate. Hanggang species level lang ako. And also they provide work area for the guests. So if may mga students na gusto mag-aral ng mga mammals or makapunta sa mga Natural History Museum, I can also help to communicate to refer them to the curators. Tsaka masaya nga sila na pag may bumibisita doon sa museum kasi na po-promote din yung collections nila kasi willing silang mag-accept ng mga students and also interns and volunteers. So what are the importance of this Natural History Museum? So like what I've said, there are a lot of importance, and isa na yun doon yung distribution ng mga species. So they are important key collections that will answer the questions from the past, present, and also future. So, kung ano yung nangyari. So, mainly, like, Natural History Museum are important in safeguarding type specimen. So, yung mga type specimen na siya yung nagiging source natin ng naming ng mga species natin. And also storage of mga important collections. Like, I saw the two extinct, hindi, nakakita nga rin ako ng Tasmanian devil na specimen sa Naturalis. So, meron sila, this one is the Hippotragus leucophaeus or the blue buck, and then the Equus quagga. So, they said that may pwede siyang kunan ng, for example, yung mga extinct species na to, pwede kunan ng ng samples, but in a non-destructive method if you want to study like molecular dating or yeah. And also the like skulls, skeletons, DNA are source of information. And comparative anatomy, or the study of comparative anatomy, di ba pumupunta tayo ng museums para makita natin kung ano yung mga itsura nila, because it's still different to see the specimen itself than to see just the picture. That's also how I appreciated the comparative anatomy, kasi si Sir Philip ginawa niya ang dami-daming bats, tapos kailangan mong i-identify for species level yung nagki-cave bio tayo, cave echo. So, but yun yung naging parang challenge sa akin, and yun yung kaya ko siya na-appreciate to study more on morphology, taxonomy, and ecology, and comparative anatomy. So what are the threats to this specimen? So number one rule, ay no food, no drinks, so that no pests. So bawal kumain talaga sa loob ng collection. So if you're inside the collection, kahit tubig, hindi nila ina-allow. Kasi, like for example, this one, yung may mga specimen, then dahil sa, ano po to?
Dermestid.
Kinakain po niya. Or may mga silverfish tayo na kinakain din yung mga, for example, mga tags. And, yan. So, nasisira yung specimen natin dahil sa mga insects. Sorry po sa mga nag-iento. So, how to conserve the specimen? Ito yung mga nakita ko dun sa mga museum na napuntahan ko. So, of course, ang pinaka-common ay naphthalene ball. Lalagyan natin ng mga mothballs para hindi sila makapunta. Ang, yun nga, yung airtight cabinets, I saw this one in the Natural History Museum in Vienna. And this is also the Natural History Museum in Vienna. So, in their rooms, meron silang humidifier or humidity controller na kinukuha yung humidity, because the number one kalaban ng specimen ay kung humid yung environment. So I was talking to them also, like they were asking me what is the main problem of specimen in our country, especially because we are tropical areas, and I said that yeah, humidity yung number one. So they are lucky that their countries are in the subtropical areas and temperate. Kaya hindi sila masyadong namumroblema doon. They only have problems in the summer time. But ours is all year round. So they were asking me how do we address this problem. And I said, even me, I don't know. Hindi ko rin alam kung paano natin i-address. Kasi, kailangan natin mga airtight cabinet siguro. Pero syempre, kailangan natin budget. And yeah, insect sticky traps. So meron sila per mga rooms na mga insect sticky traps. And in the worst case scenario, they do fumigation. So if they see that the specimen, like the one in the Hungary, na may mga insects na siya, so they fumigate it. And also, if yun lang the problem with fumigation is you cannot use the collection for minimum nila, yung mga 1 month para matanggal daw talaga lahat yung ano yung fumigate pati. Ayun lang po. Maraming salamat po. So acknowledgement dun sa area, sa mga museums sa napuntahan ko. And I have a take home message which I got it from Professor Johann Vogel in Berlin. He visited me when I was ganyan po talaga niya. He visited me when I was doing my measurements. So, ganun talaga yung binigay. So, he said that specimens were collected because they were thinking of answers to questions that hasn't been asked yet. So, thank you! Maraming salamat po!
Before we start po yung open forum, let me remind po yung attendance sheet natin and yung evaluation sheet po. Then we'll collect it after the seminar. So, now po is open na po yung for questions. So, sino po yung may question kay Ate Nina about dun sa talk niya? I see.